Πιάσ' αυτό. Πιάσ' το.
Όχι, όχι, όχι. Πάλε να... on board.
Άρε, στο εγκουασρού μεγαλεία.
Ωραία, και δεν μου λες τι θα γίνει τώρα, θα κάθομαι εγώ να στραβάω που κολυμπάτε. Πού το έδεσαι αυτό? Να κάνει τι, να τραβάει εσάς? Καλά, φτάνει, φτάνει, ωραία, περάσατε.
Γεια σου, Πέπα.
Τι λέμε. Κύριε Φλίκο, εγώ το σαράω. Γιατί έχω ξανά Ναι, ναι. Αυτό είναι το καλό από την Αργεντίνη.
Αυτό δεν είναι χρήμανος πάνω βροχή.
Έλα.
Σίγουρα έχει μπάντζι.
Μπάντζι αυτό είναι τζάμπι. Ναι,
τζάμπι. Ναι, ναι, ναι.
Είναι τζάμπι. Πω, μάλλον.
Γάματα, γάματα. Κοίτα, κοίτα, κοίτα. Ό,τι είσαι. Κόντος.
Well, that's why I wanted to try to try for them, but they live here in China.
Yeah, it is. You see the catwalk at the top, that's the upper. We'll be there also. You see some trails on the lower part. You see some trails in the jungle down there. Catwalk, we'll be there also, that's the lower. And you see the tower also. It's
yes.
Close to the tower there.
There?
That's Rivadavia Falls. That's in Argentina.
Ah, that's in Argentina.
As we get close to that fall, as you walk, you see more and more water. The biggest fall on this side, like in size, is Carlos Rossetti, Toba, has 54 meters, same height of Niagara Falls.
Like Niagara?
Yeah, in height.
In height.
There is a nice one behind the island. We see it better from Argentina.
Argentinian side.
That one, that's San Martin.
Where's San Martin?
That's San Martin, behind that.
Ah, each fall is called a name.
22 of the falls are named, only 22. But names are related to people. The only two names that make sense, people soon, they can also have well. And that was good.
Yes?
That was good. Those two names are...
Devil's Throat is where? Argentinian side?
No, between the two countries, that's the border. You'll see it in 2 minutes. That's the highest point, and you see the was plenty of water flowing to
the... Flowing the Devi throat.
Okay, let's walk before the drop.
Θα σου πάρω τέτοιο. Τέτοιο θα σου πάρω. Μου λες μετά δεν το θέλω, ε.
Όχι, δεν θέλω.
Θα σου πάρω.
Δεν θέλω.
Εγώ δεν σου πάρω ποτέ.
Εγώ δεν το θέλω.
Είσαι κατά, μπέμπα, έτσι. vagina, πρέπει.
Δες τι γίνεται στο
Μαλβόνι
τώρα.
Παμός. Αλλά εδώ είναι το κάτι άλλο, παιδιά.
Αν είχε πάρει φωτιά ο κόλλος του, θα πήγαινε κάτω. Να είναι νερό όμως, να μην είναι έτσι γκρέμια.
Θα πήγαινε. Θα πήγαινε.
Εδώ οι άλλοι επειδή ήταν από το πάει στην πίνια το κουζίδι του. Το τσιμέντο πίνι ήταν.
Φοβερό.
Φοβερό.
Βέβαια, πού είμαστε σήμερα. Πες.
Αν είχε πάρει φωτιά ο κόλλος θα πήγαινε κάτω.
Α, μια χαρά.
Μια χαρά, ε. Είναι που τσιμούν το βοβολόνο.
Θα πήρε και μια χαρά. Γιατί έχει και ένα 100 να κλειτώσει. Βλέπω τους Αργεντίνους απέναντι. Όνειρο. Εδώ έτσι πόσο ρηχά είναι και ήρεμα, δεν ξέρεις τι θα συμβεί σε λίγα, σε λίγα μέτρα, ας πούμε, θα γίνει. Θέλω να δεις. Πού είπε εδώ είσαι.
Ξέρεις τίποτα δεν συμβεί, εκτός από ότι είναι το σύννεφο.
Ναι.
Να το ρωτήσω αν από εδώ πρέπει να πάρουμε τις σαντουιτσάκια.
Μπουφ!
Τι θες? Πάλι με την φωτογραφία.
Καμιά άντα λέει optional και fazer são 600 metros e depois vamos fazer o bar. Então pelo caminho, se tiver qualquer dúvida, só perguntar no telefone. São algumas regras de segurança. Permaneça sempre sentados durante o caminho, sempre com os braços dentro da carreta. Pelo caminho nós temos algumas ortigas, então de repente se passar, depois vai ficar picando, coçando a pele de vocês, tá bom? É, liga na gente, solamente abre espanhol. English?
Yes.
So good morning. I am in Jamara, I'm your guide here in the trail. What we're gonna do now are 3 kilometers with this electric car. I'll go give you information about the fauna, flora. Then we have an optional walking trail, our 600 meters walking through the jungle. Then we go to the boat. So on the trail, if you have any questions, just ask. Just outside you, please stay seated while the wagon is moving. Stay always with your arms inside the wagon, because on the way we have some plants that are poison ivy that can sting your arms. Okay.
Ναι, και
και
τώρα αυτά, αυτά, είναι για, αυτά είναι για τους Αμερικάνους.
Ναι ρε παιδί μου και καλά.
So you have the heart of palm, all of the palm trees that you see on the way they produce. This kind that have here the name is Jussara, or we also call sweet heart of palm. You can observe a lot of palm trees between the leaves and the trunk have just a green part like 1 meter. So inside it's a hard palm without the embryonary part. If we cut the green part, take the hard palm on palm tree with that. And nowadays it contains just 1 kilo of this hard palm have to more or less 10 years. So it's the best hard palm in Brazil, but the palm tree that is in extinction. And here in the park, the seeds are spread by birds and by monkeys. So on the way to the palm trees inside. Obrigado. And
do Brasil tem outras duas espécies de palmito, que é o pupunha e o açaí. Só que eles produzem 1 quilo a cada 3 anos. Mesmo cortar só o palmito, eles recrescem, não é igual esse bicho só. Nós temos fazenda, cultivo, na colonização, e o sal é produzido com leite. Pode cortar. Nowadays in Brazil we have another 2 species of hard palm, the name are pupunha and açaí. They grow for 3 years to produce 1 kilo. We search for hard palm to grow again. So we have so far that this other one to sell because this is sad that we have here is protected by law. We cannot produce any.
Dentro
é a palavra grega,
que
significa amigo da árvore. Amigo da árvore, palavra é epíteta, só está utilizando o tronco como suporte. Utilizava as raízes do filodendro como cobre, porque era bem resistente. So, this is the big leaves, the philodendron. So, leaves here, they use the roots like a rope. Roots, put it in contact with the water, it is transformed in a natural soap. And then the Indians that lived here, they used the wood of the cibovas to make their canoes. Because the wood is light and soft, canoes 5-6 meters long. So we believe that this tree have more than 100 years old and around 25 meters high.
This tree is
Parapipedemia.
Ajiku. Ajiku means healing soul and native language. The timber is very hard and red inside. Okay? And the settlers a long time ago they use this timber a lot to produce fire. And it can endure a lot of time.
Χαλάρωσε τα λίγο ρε Πέπα.
Ε?
Χαλάρωσε τα λίγο τα Πέπα.
Τι?
Χαλάρωσε τα λίγο. Χαίρετα τα πλήθη που αλλάζουν.
We
have to run, no?
Μιλάμε τώρα,
δεν είμαστε έτσι. Ναι, ναι. Νίκ, στον Αμαζόνιο δεν θα είναι έτσι πάντως, να ξέρεις. Στην Αμαζόνη δεν θα είναι έτσι.
Μπορούμε και στην κλειδί, μπορούμε και στην.
Ναι, δηλαδή για μένα, εγώ θα προτιμούσα να φωνόμενα από μπροστά.
Ναι, βέβαια.
Ποιο είπε ότι δεν έχει φίδια.
Πού είναι τα φίδια, τα είδατε.
Αυτό το φτιάξανε λέει για τα φίδια.
Ναι, έτσι μάλιστα, γιατί αν ήταν να περπατήσουμε κάτω, τότε σίγουρα δεν θα έχει φίδια. Να βλέπεις σε γενία. Τώρα το πιλιφόρμις είναι...
Basterdiopsis. Except Rio, eh?
Except Rio, no, they have problems. But the problems we have is due to the poverty.
Yeah, of course.
That's why we have so many problems. But apart that, if you think a natural disaster,
Thank you.
πάει από το κόντο.
Ναι, βέβαια. Ωραία παπάθα, ε.
Πάρω τώρα το
λέχι,
αυτό το
λέχι. Α, καλά, εντάξει. Μα, κοίτα εδώ.
Πρόσεχε εδώ, γιατί...
Κοίτα εδώ, ρε παιδιά, οι λεπτομέρειες
Αμερικάνα, Παταγωνούλα.
Δεν σου μου να κρατάω καμία τσάντα, ρε.
Όχι, δεν θες, δεν
εδώ σου δεν θα πω να κάνω
λέει, θα ζέψει πράγμα.
Δεν ξέρω αν το βαδίσεις από πάνω πριν γίνει ο καταρακτή. Το ίδιο.
Έκανε έτσι,
ε.
Αν σου είχα βάλει
μπάρ. Τι είναι.
Μας είπε ότι και έχει πολλά
στοιχεία. Τα βλέπουμε.
Έχει πολλά βρώμικα.
Κοίτα, η Μπέπα ένα-ένα τα κατεβαίνει.
Τι δεν τα κατεβαίνει, δυο-δυο.
Ένα-ένα, μην φας τα μούτρα.
Υπάρχει
τα μούτρα σου
που
κάθε
και
τραβάς. Όχι, εδώ αρχίζει έτσι, παιδιά. Έλα, χτες είχε ρίχνει καρέκλες, δεν μας άρεσε. Όχι, φεύγουμε τώρα. Μας πάει πάνω.
Να μας πάει πάνω, πάμε μετά, να πάμε.
Πάμε στον Αργεντινή.
Δείτε μια πεταλιδάρα.
Έξι χιλιόμετρα είναι μια μισή ώρα με μια. Νομώ το κόβω να το κάνουμε αυτό.
Η ώρα είναι 2 παρά 10.
Άνετα, όλα τα προλαβαίνουμε. Πανάνετα.
Απλά θα γυρίσουμε αυτό 9. Σήμερα ήταν πολύ ωραία μέρα. Το παιδί μου.
Χθες είχε φοβερή μέρα. Λοιπόν, πώς σου φαίνεται και εγώ. Καλή εμπειρία.
Ναι.
Ωραία, δεν ήταν. Θα το κάνουμε και στο Λούσιο.
Όχι.
Ναι, χαλαρά.
Χαλαρά θα το κάνουμε στο Λούσιο.
Πού το κάνετε.
Μαζί και εσύ, τώρα πήρε το βάλτο να του πληρώσει.
Καμία σχέση.
Και στον Άραχτο θα πάμε.
Πολύ πιο ωραίο.
Να έχει λίγο ενδιαφέρον γιατί εδώ ήταν.
Ήτανε...
για νήπια.
Καλά ήταν. Ήταν καλύτερα από το θέατρο στην Ευρώπη.
Στην αρχή ήταν ωραίο, εκεί που είχε το κομμάτι εκείνο το μυστήριο. Ω, γαμάτα. Εντάξει, πεινόταν, αλλά δεν ήταν τα κύρια αυτά.
Ήταν δικός τράουτ.
Εσύ πες μας γι' αυτό, δικός πες μας τι ήταν.
Δεν το κατάλαβα ρε. Και πολύ φασαρία, ακούμε.
Αυτό του έγινε κατευθείαν στο λαρίκι. Εντάξει, ωραία ήταν, ξέρω εγώ. Πάμε.
Ναι.
Έρχεται με άερο.
Ναι. Α, ναι, ναι.
Ναι.
Είχε το καλούδι της κοντά με τον κύριο γύρω. Πολύ εντυπωσιακή.
Εδώ δεν είναι τροπικά.
Ναι.
Δεν είναι περίοδος των βροχών.
Εχθές τι είχε.
Αυτό είναι περίοδος των βροχών που θα ρίξει μια μπορίτσα.
Δεν είναι μπορείς, δεν σε έβρεχε όλη τη μέρα. Δεν ήταν καλό κύριο. Όταν ξεφορτώσει, ανοίγει ο καιρός. Θα φορτώσει πάλι. Πάλι θα ξαναβρέξει.
Δεν είναι
το λόγο, γιατί βλέπω και κάτω, το έδαφος
είναι στεγνό.
Καταρχάς.
Δεν μπορεί
να το χειροκίξει.
Το πίνει μια χαρά το πίνει.
Είναι μια... Όχι,
όχι, όχι, όχι.
Ήταν τις μουσόνες που
το πράγμα. Άλλο μουσόνας. Άλλο μουσόνας. Όχι. Μουσόνας είναι στην Ινδία και μόνο.
Oh, man. Yeah.
Εγώ δεν το ξέρω.
Καίκαμε. Ότι διακόμε. Πίσω το βιβλίο. Πώς.
Βγάλαμε και βάλαμε πράγματα που δεν είχαμε ότι έχουμε. Τι κάνει παιδί μου. Βραζιλία δεξιά.
Παραγουάι.
Παραγουάι. Ευθεία.
Three counties. We get this before, but it'll be early, it may be dark and all.
The three landmarks.
Yeah, let's keep that
for the end of the day.
I don't know if you...
It's really nice here.
It's very green, eh? Also the water is almost green. It's beautiful. I like it. It's a Turkey restaurant. There are 32,000 people in that city.
Where? Where to Iguazu?
Yeah, in the middle of the jungle there is a little city. You see the house.
The Argentinian side, eh?
On the Argentinian side. 32,000 people live there.
But the Brazilian side is much more...
Yes, 280,000.
The
city where you are.
So most people prefer to stay in Brazil, eh?
No, but they have different... The development of the Brazilian side is because of the Itaipu dam.
Or the dam.
Yeah, the dam. Many people stay to live there. And also because of tourism, of course.
Είμαστε στην αργεντινική πλευρά και μπροστά μας είναι το λαρίκι του διαβόλου.
Ωραία μάγκα.
Άλλη φάση. αυτόδιωξες, Βλάξ. Κοίτα πως παίρνει το χρώμα της συλλοσιάς, ε.
Τι σαύρα, που είναι ολόκληρο ερπετό.
Α, είναι ο σουπεριός, εσύ. Αν είναι ανούκα, εδώ
Μινά. Είδες άλλο κοντά.
Είναι μεγάλο
κοντά. Πώς λέγονται αυτά?
Αυτά λέγονται.
Τι είναι η Κορέα.
Αυτό είναι χιλουράκι, παιδιά.
Τι φέρνει, λέμε, ρε.
Ρε, αυτό είναι χιλουράκι. Μας δουλεύω, δεν έχει αγκριστό εδώ.
Λιγαρίκι, για τα τουράς, για τα μαρκάζου.
Θα κάνεις ένα ζω.
Ναι, ναι. Πολύ γέλιο.
Άρα, φώτο. Α, για να τα πει.
δούμε τι κάνει η Πέπα και όπου και ζούμε στο ποπό. Μαϊμού!
Viva Panathinaikos.
Viva Panathinaikos the best.
Kili González.
Kili González.
Sí, sí. Olímpicos.
Go down. Okay.
And you see the bridge. You see the French bridge from here. If you follow the river, yes. In white. That's the bridge between Brazil and Paraguay. And the buildings you see.
Brasilia.
Ciudad del Este, Paraguay. Ciudad del Este.
Η γέφυρα που ενώνει την Παραγουάη με την Βραζιλία.
Πού είναι η γέφυρα?
Στο πάθος του τελευταίου.
Α.
Και εδώ είναι το αργεντίνικο σύνορο. Και τι ωραία καφετέρια εκεί πέρα. Τι είπε?
Την Βραζιλία.
Τι?
Εκεί είναι Βραζιλία, λέω, εδώ είναι Αργεντινή.
Ναι, εγώ το. This is the Paraná?
Paraná.
Paraná.
Paraguay River comes from the Pantanal area and goes down and meeting
meeting plenty of rivers coming from the Andes, and also from Brazil, there is a Uruguay River, and then it becomes very big and it gets huge.
Και δυστού έρχεται εκεί το άλλο ποτάμι, μου έρχεται τις άλλες και διασχίζει ολόκληρο την Ήπειρο.
Άλλο,
ναι. Ναι, άλλο, όχι, δηλαδή. Πιο
πολύ when you visit the people, it makes you see a movie about the water, a very nice movie.
Mm-hmm.
You understand better.
That building over there, they built for the tourists.
Nice.
Yeah,
the proper shop.
Nobody's. Yeah.
Nobody goes.
Yeah, nobody goes. They call it Espaço das Américas. People go at the top. You see people there.
Yeah.
But the best view you have for Argentina.
Yeah.
From here you see both.
Because you see. Yes.
Yeah, you see. And also, especially in the afternoon, you get the sun.
Όλα τα καλά τα έχουμε για την ήρεμη. Όλα. Σύν τις σκίσεις.
Τι κλαίγεται κιόλας.
Τα
Iguazu Falls are in that way, okay? 23 kilometers.
Τα Iguazu. Α, την Iguazu River, α?
Ναι.
Iguazu είναι Παράνα.
Παράνα.
Άρα δεξιά είναι ο Iguazu και αριστερά είναι ο Παράνα. Yes, it's obvious.
They'd like to.
They would like to, but...
In Bolivia, it's a paradise.
It's a paradise. I'd be more sweet.
Propaganda brasileira. Μπήκαμε σε λάθος αίθουσα.
Νομίζω ότι ο κομμέρσιο σεξουαλ και κλίνσες αδολεσέντες ακάμπουν
θα βάλει και του Μάλμπορο τώρα.
0800-143-811 Απόιο Ιμπαϊπούμπι Νασιονάλ.
Α, γι' αυτό.
Você vai conhecer agora uma das sete maravilhas do mundo moderno. Concreto, ferro, aço. Da comunhão homem e natureza, nasce a energia sem fronteiras a iluminar o caminho de povos vizinhos. O Brasil deu um salto. Desenvolvimento. Modernidade. Entramos no século XXI como uma das 10 maiores economias do mundo. A população quase dobrou em 30 anos. E deve chegar a 180 milhões de habitantes até 2004. Gente alegre, valente, soma de crianças diferentes. Como na natureza. Tão parceira, tão generosa. Ou até banhada por muita água. 8 mil quilômetros de praias e águas salgadas. 8% da água doce do planeta. Nossos rios benzem a terra, benzem a alma do homem. Transportam e alimentam brasileiros de todos os cantos. O Rio Paraná sabe ser particularmente generoso. Aqui, a comunhão homem e natureza nasce energia elétrica. São 47 usinas de grande porte. E a maior delas é a usina hidrelétrica de Itaipu, apontada pela Sociedade Americana de Engenharia Civil como uma das 7 maravilhas do mundo moderno. Itaipu começou a nascer há milhares de anos, quando a natureza desenhou o Rio Paraná entre Brasil e Paraguai. Majestoso, caudaloso, Paranazão, como é conhecido pelos ribeirinhos. Foi na década de 50 que o décimo rio do mundo em volume de água aproximou os vizinhos. Transformar a força da água em energia daria à luz um novo futuro. Em 66, Brasil e Paraguai assinam a Ata do Iguaçu. Em 73, o Tratado de Itaipu. Em 74, nasce a Itaipu Binacional. E em maio de 1975, começa a construção da maior hidrelétrica do mundo. Multidão de homens e milhares de máquinas ocupam as margens do Rio Paraná, a 14 quilômetros de Foz do Iguaçu. Local da obra, Ilha de Itaipu, palavra indígena que significa pedra que canta. O ritmo é alucinante. Desviar o rio para construir a barragem, escavar e moldar o antigo leito, armar monumentais ferragens, lançar toneladas e toneladas de concreto. Tudo gigantesco, colossal, desafiador. Uma epopeia que chegou a contar com 40 mil trabalhadores. 7 anos depois, a barragem está pronta. Pronto o vertedouro que vai regular o nível do reservatório. Pronto o reservatório. Começa a instalação das unidades geradoras. Maio de 1984. Depois de 9 anos de obras, Itaipu começa a produzir energia. A água continua doce, mas ganha força colossal. Represada pela barragem, ela desce por um tubo de 10 metros de diâmetro e movimenta a turbina que aciona o gerador. Cada unidade geradora como esta produz 700 megawatts, o suficiente para iluminar uma cidade de 1,5 milhão de habitantes. Itaipu tem 18 unidades geradoras em operação, com potência instalada de 12.600 megawatts. 9 máquinas brasileiras e 9 paraguaias produzem 25% da energia que movimenta o Brasil e 90% da energia que movimenta o Paraguai. Planejar e construir Itaipu foi como descobrir e explorar uma gigantesca reserva de petróleo capaz de produzir, só no ano 2000, o equivalente a 54 milhões de barris. A diferença? Em primeiro lugar, não temos essa reserva. E mesmo que tivéssemos, ao contrário do petróleo, a usina hidrelétrica é uma fonte de energia inesgotável e limpa, sem poluição. Melhor para o homem, melhor para o meio ambiente.
Itaipu, para mim, simboliza que nós não podemos aceitar apenas sermos chamados de terceiro mundo, porque essa obra de engenharia nos coloca no patamar de disputa com qualquer país de primeiro mundo em qualquer momento do século passado.
Não, Lula.
Marco de referência da engenharia contemporânea, Itaipu também é modelo em gestão ambiental. Pesquisas feitas antes da formação do lago garantiram a preservação da biodiversidade. Espécies ameaçadas de extinção são reproduzidas no criadouro de animais selvagens. Mais de 20 milhões de árvores foram plantadas para proteger o lago. E a água é monitorada constantemente. A mesma água que move turbinas pensa a vida da população ribeirinha. 4 toneladas diárias de peixes garantem a sobrevivência de 500 pescadores. As cidades próximas ao reservatório agora têm praias que alimentam o lazer e o turismo. que também recebem compensação financeira pela utilização do potencial hidráulico do Rio Paraná. Itaipu já pagou ao governo do Paraná, a 16 municípios da região do Lago, no Brasil, e ao governo do Paraguai, mais de 2 bilhões de dólares. O Eco Museu é o retrato do cuidado de Itaipu com o futuro. Aqui, as novas gerações aprendem a cuidar da água, da terra e do ar. Matéria-prima da usina, a natureza é, antes de tudo, matéria-prima da vida. É a excelência em gestão que faz de Itaipu uma usina de recortes. O próximo é a ampliação da capacidade instalada para 14 mil megawatts. Duas novas unidades geradoras estão sendo implantadas e devem entrar em operação no início de 2004. Na engenharia internacional, nem a usina de Três Gargantas, em construção na China, terá condições de produzir mais energia que Itaipu. A generosidade do Rio Paraná é maior do que a do Rio Yangtze, onde se localiza a usina chinesa. Se há um lugar onde a natureza sabe abençoar a vida com a melhor energia, é este: América do Sul. Vizinhança entre Brasil, Paraguai e Argentina. Espetáculo da fauna e da flora no Parque Iguaçu. Mais o espetáculo dos rios. Visitantes de todo o mundo, como Bill Clinton, se encantam.
I have seen pictures for many years, but no one could possibly know what it's like unless you come and see it. It's unbelievable. It's beautiful.
Antes, Eleanora Roosevelt, esposa de outro presidente norte-americano, não teria se contido. Pobre Niagara Falls. São as águas do Iguaçu brindando a vida em sua forma mais forte.
Por Niagara Falls.
Esplêndida. E logo adiante, o coração, que o homem soube deixar ainda mais generoso ao construir uma das sete maravilhas do mundo moderno. Itaipu. Comunhão homem e natureza. Um gigante de concreto, ferro e aço, com alma brasileira e paraguaia. A pedra canta qualidade de vida em ritmo de samba e guarani. E a água doce, cheia de energia, faz sua vigorosa coreografia. Dança e dança.
Guarani Indians to a rocky island that existed in the middle of the Paraná River, near the place where the dam was built. The water of the river, on striking the rocks, made a unique sound that the Indians called Itaipu, which in the Guarani language means the rock that sings.
Itaipu Binacional é resultado de um tratado assinado em 26 de abril de 1973 entre o Brasil e o Paraguai. Esse tratado estabeleceu que a energia produzida pela hidrelétrica seria dividida igualmente entre os dois países e definiu a possibilidade de um país comprar da Itaipu a energia que o outro não utilizasse, como ocorre atualmente. A central hidrelétrica começou a ser construída em 1975 e ficou pronta em 1991.
Itaipu Binacional é o resultado de um tratado firmado el 26 de abril de 1973 entre Brasil e Paraguai. Ese tratado estableció que la energía producida por la hidroeléctrica sería dividida igualmente entre los dos países y definió la posibilidad de que un país pueda comprar la energía que el otro no utilizase, como ocurre actualmente. La central comenzó a ser construida en 1975 y fue terminada en 1991.
Itaipu Binacional is the result of a treaty signed on April 26th of 1973 between Brazil and Paraguay. This treaty established that the energy generated by the hydroelectric plant would be equally divided between the two countries and also determined the possibility that one country could buy the energy the other did not use, like what is happening at present. The construction of the power plant began in May of 1975 and was finished in 1991.
A primeira estrutura que vocês vão ver é o vertedouro da usina. Ele foi construído para escoar a água que não passa pelas turbinas. Basicamente, o vertedouro só é aberto quando existe excesso de água no reservatório. O vertedouro tem capacidade para escoar 62 milhões de litros de água por segundo.
Cargar el agua que no pasa por las turbinas. Básicamente, el vertedero solo se abre cuando existe excedente de agua en el embalse. El vertedero tiene capacidad para descargar 62 millones de litros de agua por segundo, un volumen 40 veces mayor que la cantidad normal de agua de las cataratas del Iguazú.
The first structure that you will see is the spillway. It was built to discharge the water that does not go through the turbines. In reality, that spillway is only open when the amount of water in the reservoir is greater than what the turbines require. The spillway can discharge over 62 million liters of water per second, a volume over 40 times greater than the average flow of the Iguazu Falls.
Thank you.
But normally two or three are in maintenance.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, there are two new turbines.
What is the 18A? You see at the end?
Yes, it looks so new.
Yeah, that's new. And the other one is...
I can see the kind of building, yes. Yeah.
There will be 20 turbines. This is the first thing. They will need more water. Okay? And then it will be difficult in the future to see that thing open.
Mm-hmm.
Because we need it.
More water, there will not be surplus.
They're releasing the water. You see that there?
Yes.
The water is coming from the bottom. Because they're releasing the water. This is the beer.
Ωραία, μάγκα, τι έχουν κάνει οι άνθρωποι. Άλλαξε η ιστορία, η πορεία της Βραζιλίας μέχρι τώρα. Καλά, η Παραγουάη δεν το συζητάμε. Ποια θες. Αυτό με την Πέμπα. Κοίτα, έχει χώρο για να βάλουν κι άλλες τουρμπίνες δεξιά, βλέπεις.
Έχει άλλη μία.
Μια χαρά, μια χαρά.
Ναι, αλλά θα πω
δεν έχει αρκετό νερό.
Δεν έχει αρκετό νερό.
Ναι, ναι. Τρεις κρατάνε για, λέει, για συντήρηση και τις υπόλοιπες δουλεύουν. Πάντα δύο-τρεις λέει είναι εκτός τέτοιου για να κάνουν συντήρηση. Λογικό είναι. Ωραία μάγκα.
Σκεφτείτε μόνο το κτίριο ρε παιδί μου. Αυτό που είναι η γραφεία της κατάγειας.
Δείτε πόσο μικρό φαίνεται από εδώ.
Ναι, αυτό.
Οι τουρμπίνες έχουν 10 μέτρα διάμετρο και τις βλέπεις τώρα και λες είναι σιγά τι είναι. Είναι γιγάντιο το έργο.
Φυσικά προσπαθώ να δω κανέναν άνθρωπο.
Πού να τον δεις.
Μόνο τα μάτια αν συγκρίνεις το μέγεθος.
Ναι, ναι, βλέπεις.
Άρα στη κλίμακα είναι λάθος αυτό που είδα.
Ένα προς 100 έλεγε.
Είχε πολύ μεγάλο λόγο στον άνθρωπο.
Ναι, καλά, ο άνθρωπος εντάξει μπορεί να είναι μαλαγία.
Ποντικό φάρμακο.
Ναι.
Ούτε και τα κομμενάκια.
Están ubicadas tres turbinas. The area where the plant is located is considered a neutral zone between the two countries. The work is done together by Brazilians and Paraguayans. The frontier in this area is only symbolic and is located in the center of the main dam between units 9 and 10. One of the first construction jobs executed was the excavation of the diversion channel in 1975. It took 3 years to build it. After draining the original riverbed, the main dam and powerhouse were built there. Three turbines are located in the diversion channel.
A barragem principal tem 2.600 metros de extensão e na base chega a uma largura de 273 metros, o equivalente a quase 3 quarteirões. Sua altura máxima é de 196 metros, a mesma altura de um edifício de 65 andares. O comprimento da barragem de concreto, rocha e terra chega a quase 8 quilômetros.
La represa principal tiene 2.600 metros de extensión y llega a un ancho de 273 metros, equivalente a casi 3 cuadras. Su altura máxima es de 196 metros, la misma altura de un edificio de 65 pisos. La longitud de la represa de hormigón, roca y tierra llega a casi 8 kilómetros.
The main dam is 2,600 meters long, and the width of its base reaches 273 meters, equivalent to almost 3 city blocks. Its maximum height is 196 meters, the same as a 65-story building. The length of the concrete, rock fill, and earth fill dam is almost 8 kilometers.
A água que movimenta as turbinas passa pelos enormes tubos brancos localizados na barragem principal. Cada um deles tem mais de 10 metros de diâmetro e uma vazão de 700 metros cúbicos de água por segundo. Até chegar às turbinas, a água cai de uma altura de 112 metros.
El agua que mueve las turbinas pasa por los inmensos tubos blancos ubicados en la represa principal. Cada uno tiene más de 10 metros de diámetro y caudal de 700 metros cúbicos de agua por segundo. Hasta llegar a las turbinas, el agua cae de una altura de 112 metros.
The water that turns the turbines passes down the huge white pipes called penstocks at the main dam. The inner diameter of each penstock is over 10 meters and its discharge 700 cubic meters per second. Before entering the turbines, the water falls from a height of 112 meters.
No auge da construção, as centrais de concreto produziam material suficiente para fazer um edifício de 25 andares a cada hora, marcando sucessivos recordes mundiais. Foram lançados 12 milhões e 500 mil metros cúbicos de concreto, o que daria para construir 210 estádios iguais ao Maracanã. Com o ferro e o aço utilizados, seria possível construir 380 torres Eiffel.
En el apogeo de la construcción, las centrales de hormigón producían material suficiente para construir un edificio de 25 pisos a cada hora, marcando sus
concrete batch plants produced enough material to build a 25-story building every hour, successively breaking world records. About 12,500,000 cubic meters of concrete were used for the construction, enough to build 210 stadiums like the Maracanã in Rio. With the iron and steel used, it would be possible to build 380 Eiffel Towers.
O mede 170 quilômetros de comprimento por 7 quilômetros de largura média. Sua profundidade máxima é de 180 metros. possui 29 bilhões de metros cúbicos de água acumulada. Além de fornecer água para as turbinas, o reservatório pode ser usado para lazer, esportes náuticos, pesca e irrigação.
El embalse mide 170 kilómetros, tiene 29 mil millones de metros cúbicos de agua acumulada. Además de suministrar agua para las turbinas, el embalse puede ser utilizado para recreación, deportes náuticos, pesca e irrigación.
The reservoir is 170 kilómetros long and 7 kilómetros wide on average. Its maximum depth is 180 meters. The volume of accumulated water it contains is 29 billion cubic meters. Besides supplying water to the turbines, it can be used for leisure activities, water sports, fishing and irrigation.
A Itaipu Binacional desenvolve na sua área de abrangência vários programas ambientais. O plantio de mais de 17 milhões de mudas de árvores tem como objetivo proteger o lago do depósito de sedimentos. Nos refúgios biológicos são criados em cativeiro animais que estão ameaçados de extinção.
Itaipu Binacional desarrolla en su área de alcance varios programas ambientales. El plantío de 17 millones de mudas de árboles tiene como objetivo proteger el embalse de la sedimentación. En los refugios biológicos son criados en cautiverio los animales amenazados de extinción.
Itaipu Binacional develops various environmental programs in the area of influence of its reservoir. Over 17 million seedlings were planted in order to protect the lake from soil erosion and sediment deposits. Animals in danger of extinction are reproduced in captivity for subsequent release into the biological refuges.
16 municípios no Brasil e 8 no Paraguai margeiam o reservatório e são chamados de municípios lindeiros. Todos recebem uma compensação financeira mensal chamada de royalties. Desde 1991, Itaipu já paga cobertura turística e oferecem uma boa opção de lazer. No verão recebem mais de 300 mil pessoas que praticam várias modalidades de esportes.
16 municipalidades brasileiras e 8 em Paraguai contornam o embalse e são chamadas de municipalidades lindeiras. Todas reciben una compensación financiera llamadas royalties. Desde 1991, Itaipú ya pagó en royalties cerca de 1.500 millones de dólares. Las playas artificiales del embalse tienen una gran infraestructura turística y ofrecen una buena opción de recreación. En el verano reciben más de 300.000 personas que practican varias modalidades de deportes.
16 municipalities in Brazil and 8 in Paraguay that border the lake every month receive monetary compensation called royalties. Since 1991, Itaipu has already paid in royalties about $1.5 billion. The artificial beaches of the Itaipu Lake are provided with ample tourist infrastructure and offer a good recreational option. In summer, over 300,000 people enjoy the beaches and practice various water sports.